Okay, so welcome back to my video. So this is biology form 5. We are still learning chapter 6, sexual reproductions in flowering plants. Mark 12 verse 30, love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength. So today we will learn subtopic 6.3, pollination and fertilization. So what is pollination? Pollination is the process of transferring the pollen grains from the anther to the stigma. Okay, so this process is known as pollination. So pollination is assisted by pollinating agents such as insects, mammals, birds, water, or wind. So human also one of the pollinating agents. Okay? So the presence of pollen grains on the stigma after pollinations occur, it will trigger the process of fertilization. So example, in this photograph 6.6, pollination is assisted by bees. Okay, so bees is insect. So it's also pollinating agent. So figure 6.7 shows the formations of pollen tube and male gametes. So we go step by step. Step 1, the wall of anther from mature pollen will dry, shrink and split. Pollen grains in the pollen sac are released. So this is anther. So the wall of anther will dry, shrink and split, and then it will produce the pollen grain. Okay? So step number 2, the released pollen grain are transferred to the stigma. So this is stigma. Okay, this is stigma. So now the pollen grain transferred to the stigma of the same flower or different flowers by pollinating agent. Okay, pollinating agent. And then the third one, the pollen grains that have been transferred to the stigma will germinate. Okay, the pollen grain transferred to the stigma germinate, dia bercambah, forming a pollen tube. So this is pollen tube. Okay, pollen tube. The pollen tube will grow down towards the ovule through the style. Okay, so this is the pollen grain. The pollen grain, dia germinate to pollen tube, and then dia akan grow down towards the ovule here through the style. Okay? And then the fourth one, the generative nucleus will move along the pollen tube towards the ovule. Generative nucleus. So this is mature pollen. We have generative nucleus, okay, and also the tube nucleus. So the generative nucleus also move along the pollen tube towards the ovule. At the same time, the generative nucleus will divide by mitosis to form two male gametes. So this one, the generative nucleus, dia akan form two male gametes here. This one and this one, haploid. So they divide to form two male gametes, haploid, by mitosis. And then step number 5, the end of the pollen tube will secrete an enzyme to digest the tissues of the style. Okay, so when it reach the embryo sac, okay, the pollen tube will penetrate the ovule through the micropyle. So micropyle here is the opening to the embryo sac. Okay, so the tube nucleus will degenerate and both male gametes will enter the embryo sac now. So itu adalah bagaimana pollen tube terhasil dan male gametes also form. Okay, so here this is the micropyle. So the male gametes now will enter. Okay, enter the embryo sac. So fertilization will be proceed. Okay, so what happened next? Double fertilization here means two fertilization. In the formations of the first one, diploid zygote and also triploid nucleus. Okay, so double fertilizations here involve two male gametes. So previously here we know we have two male gametes. So two male gametes, the first male gamete fertilize the egg cell, so it will form diploid zygote, and then the second male gamete, it will fuse with the polar nuclei to form a triploid endosperm tissues. Okay, the generative nucleus undergo mitosis in the pollen tube to produce two male gametes. So the male gametes are haploids. So the male gametes, both of the male gametes, will enter the embryo sac for fertilization. So in the embryo sac, double fertilizations occur. Okay, you need to remember double fertilization. The first male gamete fertilize the egg cell to form the diploid zygote, and then the second male gamete, it will fuse with the polar nuclei to form triploid endosperm tissue. So here, double fertilizations in flowering plants. When it reaches the embryo sac, the pollen tube will penetrate the ovule through the micropyle. So here, this is the pollen tube. So this is the pollen. This is the pollen tube. Okay, and then this is stigma. The male gamete here, haploid, and we have one tube nucleus. So tube nucleus di sini dia seperti driver. Dia drive the male gametes menuju ke embryo sac. So now what happened? The pollen tube, when it reach the embryo sac, pollen tube will penetrate the ovule through the micropyle opening. The tube nucleus will then degenerate, and now the male gametes, the two male gametes, will enter the embryo sac. Okay, enter the embryo sac. So one of the male gametes will fertilize the egg cell and produce diploid zygote, and the second male gamete fuse with the two polar nuclei, this one, two polar nuclei, to form a triploid endosperm nucleus. So this is double fertilization in flowering plants. Okay, remember double fertilization means two fertilization. Okay, you should remember the first one produce what and the second one produce what. So importance of double fertilization for the survival of flowering plants. Okay, so double fertilizations is important for the survival of the flowering plants. The fusions of one of male gametes with the egg cells will produce zygote. Okay, it will produce zygote. So genetic information during this process, the genetic information is passed down from one generation to the next generation, and also it restores the haploid condition in the gametes with the formations of diploid zygote. So meaning haploid plus haploid form diploid zygote. The fusions of another male gamete with the two polar nuclei that produce endosperm tissue. This endosperm tissue used for the development of an embryo for the survival of the plant species. In eudicots, ini adalah istilah baru yang kita gunakan untuk dicotyledon. So now we are using term eudicots. Okay, such as legumes, kacang-kacang, mangoes, and mustard. The endosperm is fully utilized by the embryo to develop before the seed matures. In most monocots, such as coconut, wheat, barley, and corn, only a part of the endosperm is utilized for the development of an embryo. Okay, some of them are stored in the cotyledon to be utilized during the germination of the seed. The endosperm tissue enables the embryo to survive in the seed for a long time if the conditions are not favorable for germination to occur. So again, the importance of endosperm tissue, okay, to enables the embryo to survive. So this is the importance of double fertilization for the survivals of flowering plants. So that's all for today. So next video we will learn another subtopics about developments of seeds and fruits. Okay, thank you.